Hey, Bill.
Hi, it's Mr. Carlin.
Should we just lower the music maybe, but not turn it off?
I got it, Mr. Carlin.
Here.
Right, Jack.
Who's that, Kurt Douglas?
Yeah, Jack Riley. Mr. Carlin from the Bob Newhart Show.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So I got him.
That's right.
Here's some of our guys.
That's Kevin Spacey.
Yeah, he's famous. Yeah. Fruit. Oh, Shelley Berman. I love him. The first, he was before Newhart with the telephone
with
stuff.
The telephone. Yeah.
Steve going to want to play a song?
Wow, that's cool.
Hey, good. There's
more. I don't know. I believe there's more.
Open with a song, maybe.
We know some of these guys.
Tom
Pat Harrington, Tom Poston, Peter Marshall.
Oh, yeah.
Gary Owens.
Oh, yeah. Dick Van Patten.
That's his original hair. Dick
Tuesday
Van Patten.
Night, we're having our dinner at...
Okay, let me see.
Let's get a handheld camera.
There's a whole bunch of guys in this?
Yeah.
Hey, do you know Shaggy Green?
Yeah. I don't know him, but I know. I've heard of him. Yeah, yeah.
You got to get him, man.
Yeah.
Seriously.
The second Tuesday of every month, we have a dinner.
Oh, I never had a dinner. You never had a dinner, right?
No, I've not had a dinner, no. I was invited to a dinner.
Tuesday night.
Alan just showed up at the house.
I'd love to see that.
Alan just showed up at the house the other day and said, hey, how are you? I used to live here for 30 years. I was doing the morning show. It was the first.
Okay, now.
You didn't know the comedian... I
did not know that a comedian lived here for 30
years. So this
has
heritage.
Yeah.
Like Steve Allen has heritage at The Tonight Show and Jay Leno is doing it.
This has
heritage here.
Yeah, there's some comedy energy in these walls. 30 years he lived here, doing comedy the whole time.
Yeah.
Friends with Nicholson.
And you didn't know that.
They're doing a piece in Playboy on me.
You showed up. Here's another quirky thing, okay? I'm sitting there watching The View, okay? Rosie was on fire.
Yeah, she gets. She's crazy.
She was about to bring on Regis. The second Regis is about to come out. Tom Green this morning is starting. The doorbell rings. It's you.
Yeah.
You're friends with Regis.
With Rosie.
You've done a movie with Rosie.
Called Exit to Eat. It was a softcore porn.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Really? Barry Marshall.
Aykroyd. Dan Aykroyd, right?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Dan Aykroyd.
Yeah.
We just know the Canadian.
Dan Aykroyd's
exactly
awesome.
A great movie.
Awesome. Do you know him well?
No, I don't know him well, but he took me to a fucking party that was like the craziest thing ever.
Oh really? Yeah.
Dan Aykroyd. His whole life's a party.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he's amazing. Wait, we're actually on the air right now.
Yeah.
Pretty cool. Do you want to
Shaggy?
Want to turn the volume down? Hello, everybody. How you doing? Welcome to the show.
Hey, we got a guy. Shaggy is agreeing with me. We're both agreeing with you as a guy.
Yeah.
From different generations, I say Shaggy would be the best guest ever.
Shaggy Green, yeah.
Yeah, he says he's the best.
Yeah. And can you get him up here?
I took him to our dinner one night. You see who's here. Shaggy Green, Tom Poston.
Yeah. You think those guys want to come
up? I'll get Shaggy,
Harvey Korman, Tim Conway.
Yeah, why don't you and Shaggy come on together?
He killed
He's the best. He almost never does interviews. But he came up to, this was at Cantor's. No, not Cantor's, Nate Nowles. And he comes up to me, he's like, you work at the Laugh Factory and stuff? You get gigs around town? I'm like, yeah. And he's like, you think you can get me a gig? Like, I was talking to Jamie.
Right.
I go, you're Shecky Green.
Yeah.
Like, if you put your name, you know, on a thing, Shecky Green, Shecky is like synonymous for comic. Your first name is a synonym
shouldn't
for
be a
stand-up comedian. Yeah.
Well, you guys.
Whereas if they haven't,
Well, he lives in Palm Springs now.
Palm Springs. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well,
but next time he's in town.
Shecky Green, next time you're in town, please come by the Webovision, the National Webovision. It's are we on the air now? Are we doing a show now? Yeah, this is exciting.
It's 8:19.
What's your name again, sir?
Brock.
Yeah, you're a volunteer here, right?
Yes, sir.
Thanks so much for helping out.
What if he wasn't?
Yeah, no, I know.
None of this is going on. This show is just a guy.
That's happened. People have just wandered in off the street, grabbed a camera.
I'm sorry.
This is only on his end.
We don't even have. Yeah, no, exactly. No one's watching. I mean, we could literally. Are we on the air, Bill?
Yeah.
Well, this is exciting. We have Norm Macdonald here tonight hanging out. And we have Alan Kent here tonight, who just showed up. And
there he's
Steve,
sitting right in the red shirt.
Thanks for coming, Norm. This
is
awesome.
Thanks, man.
Are we? Now we're gonna.
Yeah, this is like a.
We're gonna sit down. And we're gonna take some Skype calls on the video Skype tonight from you people.
Oh yeah, you
as well as take some phone calls.
You don't know where it is. How are you gonna tell me?
We also have Steve here tonight. What are you performing as?
Just myself, Steve.
Just a Steve tonight. No character, nothing?
Nothing. This is raw.
Yeah.
We're Jerry's in Westwood, up in the backward room.
True self.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Tim Conway, Harvey Korman, everybody.
Okay, great. You're going to play a couple of songs for us?
Sure.
Okay. I wonder, should we open with a song and then start the show? Maybe, Steve, you could start with a song.
Sure, that's a vaudeville maxim.
There you go.
Is it? Really? Well, there we go. That's good.
I got the perfect song.
Are you going to come to our dinner Tuesday?
Yeah, you know, I think I can. I might have to come a little later, though, because I do my show at 8.
Can I come? We're usually through out of there by 9.
Oh, you're out by 9, huh? Okay, we'll figure it out. You ever, let's talk about it in a minute.
Tom has the best.
Maybe I take a night off the show, maybe.
Tom is the best out for anything social.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Man, I'm having a barbecue.
I got a TV show.
Yeah, I know. You can't tune in and check out if I'm lying. You know what I mean? It's like
okay, WebOvision.
Here
we go.
Wait, does anyone need another drink?
Anybody need a drink? Last call.
Beverage.
Hey, and let's have a big hand for Norm Macdonald, too, here tonight on the channel, everybody. Wait, are you really going back to the Playboy
Mansion? Yeah, they're doing a piece on me in the magazine.
Oh, my gosh, really? Wow. Well, you know, are you leaving right now?
In 56 years, I'm still Alan who?
Yeah.
Nobody knows my name.
I know.
Nobody knows my
name. Am I on?
Are you leaving right now, Alan?
Next 2 or 3 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Come on. I'll be right back.
Hey, well, thanks for coming. That was awesome. We're actually on the air on this thing right now.
He's trying to sing.
How's it going?
Sing.
I'm ready.
Yeah.
Go.
Okay, here we
go. No, that's cool. Yeah, Steve's going to sing. Let's go over here.
It's a little... This is a little kind of calypso song.
Thank you, guys. We'll be back in a minute. We'll be back in a second.
It's a little calypso number. So it's imagine a man on the ground praying to the Lord. It goes like this. It goes, "Well, are you there, Lord? It's little old me. I'm just making a simple inquiry. As I've traveled down life's path, I wonder what I did to incur your wrath. Well, I'm making just a simple request. I don't mean to be a big pest. I really want to know so bad exactly what I did to make you so mad. Yeah, what did I do to deserve this fate? Everyone around me is so happy. I tell you, I must admit that I'm not feeling great. As a matter of fact, I'm feeling crappy. Well, it's true, Lord, I took your name in vain. I didn't mean it, let me explain. Life is so hard every day, and everyone else seems to be okay. Yeah, what did I do to deserve this fate? Everyone around me is so crappy. I tell you, I must admit that I'm not feeling great. As a matter of fact, I'm feeling crappy. I didn't ask to be born, I'm not asking to die. All I'm asking you, dear Lord, is why did you have to treat me this way? Yeah! And then one day, she came into my life. I'm so happy, gonna make her my wife. And so, dear Lord, I ask you once more, exactly what I did to win your ardor. Yeah, what did I do to deserve this fate? Everyone around me is so crappy. I tell you, I must admit that I'm feeling great. As a matter of fact, I'm feeling happy. What happened? Where's the... All right. Okay. I guess I have no choice. The I'll do one. I'll do something about where the banana lives in the house called the refrigerator. This is a song called Refrigerator. Listen to what the wise men say. Listen to what the wise men say. Listen to what the wise men say. He says, sometimes the fridge is too hot. The food, it starts to rot. Sometimes the fridge is too cold. The food, she starts to grow mold. But when the fridge is just right, it'll keep food fresh all night. Here we go, yeah. Refrigerator. Everybody sing along, yeah. Refrigerator. Oh, well, we live in a nation of refrigeration, keeping it cold. Oh, well, sometimes you got to move. The fridge she got to come to. If you leave her behind, another fridge you must find. If that fridge is at the top of the stairs, you know that fridge ain't going anywhere. No, no, no. Refrigerator. Everybody now. Refrigerator. Oh, well, we live in a nation of refrigeration, keeping it cold. Well, if some fridges are frost-free, she is a lot of money. The kind that you got to defrost, she is one half of the cost. Whether they're big or they're small, well, it's hard to live without a fridge at all. One more time, everybody, yeah. Refrigerator. I'm talking refrigerator. Oh, well, we live in a nation of refrigeration, keeping it cold. Why don't you listen to what the wise man say? Listen to what the wise man say. I say, listen to what the wise man say. Listen to what the wise. Thank you. Well, I'm worried of a sweat. You guys, what happened? Where are the people? Okay, now. Okay, we're going to switch it up a little. Let's see. What are we going to do? Any requests? No, no, I don't do that. No. I asked for a request. Yeah, wait. I'm ready. Go for it, dude.
Playboy Mansion. Hey, Norm, do you want to have a seat here? And then no, Steve, you stand there, and we'll just sit down and take a Skype for a second?
Oh, let's take some Skypes.
Yeah, come on in. Have,
just so you don't think I'm
Skype it up.
I don't think you're bullshit at all. You have the cutest.
Maybe we should...
That's my wife and I.
Yeah, let's turn the music down.
Now, this was taken 20 years ago.
Yeah, right? Bill, can you turn it
off? Look at the difference. This was taken about a month ago.
Yeah, we should settle into the show.
Yeah, that was great. Yeah.
That is awesome.
It's, you know.
Oh, I can go turn it
terrible.
Off. Do you have my keys?
It was awesome.
20
what?
Years.
What did you say? It was terrible?
I said it was a parable. It was a terrible parable.
Oh, it was a parable, yeah.
We have a dinner.
Yeah, it was a parable.
My group, here. Let me show you.
Norm Macdonald is here, everybody. On the Web of Vision. Hello at home.
This is
hello. Thank you for... Oh, we're on camera three. Steve, that was awesome.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you. We've got the music off now. It's actually kind of...
Kevin Spacey.
These young ladies here wanted to do a shot of Jägermeister.
Yeah. Just look for the ones you...
Thank
you
very
much. Can they do the guys from Kentucky?
Are you... Are you girls of legal age to drink here?
No.
Yeah, are you? Really? Can we see some identification
proof? Pat Harrington, Tom Poston, Gary Owen, Dick Van Patten.
Where did you guys come from? What are your names?
Harvey Korman.
I'm joking. What are your...
Christy, how are you? Nice to meet you. Wow, it's quite the party, isn't it?
Yeah.
Alan Kent was here.
I've done 15 movies. Nobody
is Alan still here?
I know your name, Alan.
Did you see
Steve's here? Norm Macdonald's here?
Yeah. Steve sang a song.
Steve sang a song?
I heard that.
Two songs.
Are we doing a shot of Jägermeister?
Oh, yes. Bottoms
okay.
up.
Are you doing one, Norm? Or? Not. We don't have to rush into that.
Tell me,
Norm and I are drinking some vodka.
Tom is getting me back into booze.
No, that's not true. No, you.
I was telling Tom I hadn't had a drink in 1,100 days in 6 hours. And I was like, I use a goddamn drink, man. It's been a long time. But I'm way out of practice. So Tom has me on this regimen.
That's not a, yeah, it wasn't exactly like that, but.
So if it's supposed, if I'm supposed to do a Jägermeister, I'll do it, whatever.
Yeah, we'll do one later. We'll do Jägermeister later. Cheers. Cheers, everyone, to a good Friday night. Here, it's 8:30 in Los Angeles.
Already did that.
Let's, hey, Steve, I was thinking, actually, because DJ Easy Mike was going to be here tonight, but he couldn't make it. He was going to be sort of playing jazzy music in the background tonight. We were going to try to go to for sort of a party a vibe. But you could sort of play low jazzy. And we can just check out this. Look, here we have our first ever dorm party.
This reminds me of a party, man. That's what I like to do at a party. Like, you know, just have a couple of drinks with a couple of ladies and look at a computer.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's going that way around here. Look at this. But these guys are in Wisconsin at a dorm party. Look at this, Steve. Steve, look at this for a second. What?
Come, do we have to do Jägermeister?
Come around, look at this. Come look at this. Come look at this for a second.
No, I just want.
I actually want Steve to come see this. Get us chair over here for Steve on the side here. Look at this.
Yes, accepted.
I like this.
These guys are at a party in Wisconsin.
Hey!
Look at this. You know what I mean? Hey, how are you guys doing in Wisconsin?
Party. We need to see some ID. Can you guys put some ID up to the screen?
Tom, this is you, buddy.
How are you guys doing? Yes. Now, what are you guys, what's going on in the dorm tonight? We're here. Do you have a question for Norm? Anything you'd like to talk about?
I do. We want to know if Norm's working on any more projects recently.
I hate that fucking question. This is the worst question.
You just turned it
back.
You just turned it into a talk show.
No, you know, you may have won like the 50,000th person ever asked that fucking question.
I'm the man in charge.
One more question. Another question. A weirder question.
How long? Norm, I want to know.
Wait, we want to know about you guys for a second. How many people are in the room there?
We got.
Okay, I'm going to take it on Wi-Fi.
Take it on Wi-Fi. Take us on a little tour. See, these guys are at a college.
Yeah.
Let's find out who we're dealing with here before we just sort of jump into this thing willy-nilly here. I don't know about these guys. Wait. Oh, did we just lose their connection?
Oh, that sucks.
No. We'll call them back. We'll get those guys back. I can call them back.
Tom, you know I am excited. Are the guys gone from the?
They're gone, but that's weird, isn't it?
Guys from the computer are gone.
Yeah,
it's exciting that this is. We were talking about this is the first time you got a teleprompter, right?
Oh yeah.
So that's exciting.
Yeah, it is.
Does everybody know that?
No, I haven't told anybody that.
Oh, yet. You should announce it, man. People are gonna be fucking surprised.
And then after, should we roll the opening for the show? Right after I show the
like
new teleprompter,
like
and then we roll it, and then we come back, and the show's officially started. Like we've segued into
That's
the show.
Perfect.
Okay.
You got a sense of the drama.
Good evening, everyone. President Bush says the troops in Iraq face a learning enemy, an enemy that is learning how to shoot down American choppers. 28 troops and civilian contractors killed in less than 3 weeks. Another crash today. Insurgents already claiming responsibility. More on that shortly, and what is being done to counter the growing threat. We begin, however, tonight with astronaut Lisa Nowak, a day after being charged in Florida with trying to kidnap and kill a woman who she may have seen as a romantic rival. She's back in Houston. She's grounded. NASA promising big changes to screen out unstable recruits. More is coming to light as well about what led up to her strange trip cross-country wearing diapers. More to her about her alleged target and the other astronaut caught in the middle. We will have all the angles tonight, including a closer look at the romantic obsession with Dr. Drew Pinsky. We begin in Houston with the latest and CNN's Ed Lavandera. one, Angelique.
Did they change the...
That was a lot of fun, though. That's the new teleprompter.
Did they change the teleprompter? It looked like they were going ahead. I wanted to hear it again.
We just have the same thing. We downloaded that from CNN. That was Anderson Cooper.
No, I understand, but can we play it again? Because I want to see one thing that was said in it.
Oh, yeah, sure, yeah. Yeah, back that up, Bill. Yeah, we actually have a control. This is how high-tech it is. I actually purchased this myself.
Why is he going slower? Good evening, everyone.
He'll go as fast as you read,
Okay, good evening, everyone. President Bush says the troops in Iraq face a learning enemy, an enemy that is learning how to shoot down American choppers. 28 troop and civilian contractors have been killed in less than 3 weeks. Another crash today. Insurgents already claiming responsibility. More on that shortly. And what is being done to counter the growing threat? We begin ever tonight with astronaut, what's her thing?
Lisa Nowak.
Lisa Nowak, day after being charged in Florida with trying to kidnap and kill a woman whom she may have seen as a romantic rival. Mm-hmm. She's back in Houston.
Yes.
She's grounded.
I think they mean grounded in the sense she can't go up to space, not like you're grounded, but I see what you're saying.
They've said for the first 14 sentences, like the craziest thing you've ever heard, and then they go, she's been grounded.
Yeah. Read that back again. You're right, that does look strange. Well,
why do you spare the rod and spoil the children.
Yeah.
But Jesus Christ.
They could come up with a better punishment than that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Than a grounding.
She's an astronaut, and the judge rules she's not a flight risk.
She's not a flight risk.
She's an astronaut. Tom, check this out, man. Is that Mike part? That part Mike did all?
No, so do it.
Is she in it? What was it again?
She's an astronaut, and the judge ruled she's not a flight risk.
Yeah, she's an astronaut, and she's been let go. The judge decided she was not a flight risk.
Oh, these guys are back. She's grounded.
Yeah, she's grounded.
Yeah.
She can't go out.
She's
got to be in her living room listening to Pink Floyd.
Oh, yeah, probably.
She's grounded.
Oh, yeah. She seems like a Floyd listener, too. Best and the brightest.
Hey, Norm.
NASA.
Hey, guy, man, what's up?
Would you guys like to see some young, fresh women on the
screen? Not if that's you. it's the guy with the fucking cigar again.
Yeah, I called him back.
we want to see if the girls aren't like... we're watching the Bowery Boys right now, and you're saying you got naked ladies?
Where are the ladies there in Wisconsin?
There's a big celebration for the girls tonight, because it's like there's like 10 girls, and it's all their birthday.
Hello,
there's a lady. Hello there, how are you? Say hello to Norm Macdonald here and Angelique.
Hi.
We're here in Los Angeles, California.
We didn't really mean say hi.
I'm Tom. This is what's your name, young lady?
Jess.
And what, are you in school there? Are you enrolled in school?
Yeah.
What are you taking in school there?
Everything.
Really?
Are you from... does she go to UCLA?
That's bull crap. She's...
Well, these guys are in Wisconsin right now.
Oh, it says WUSC. I thought it said everything.
Oh, yeah. What school is this that you're all at?
Carthage.
Oh, okay. You want to show
us... You've never heard of it, trust us.
University of Carthage.
The University of Carthage? You come from the past? We have... this thing keeps getting more complicated, this computer. I didn't know we could talk to Carthaginians.
Apparently.
It's a private school everyone can get into.
Look at you guys. Now, hey, look at... What's your name again, sir? Orange hat?
Andrew.
I know, I'm sorry.
Like it's not more fun to call him Orange hat.
Andrew, look in the camera when you talk, because you always look at the screen. You got to look in the camera. Yeah, there you
go. I'm using my roommate's computer. I'm not used to it. I'm using Tim's computer.
He just told you to look in the camera. Now you're making love to the fucking camera.
Look at that. Look at that on the look at that shot though. Isn't that interesting? Look at the
screen. Wow.
There they are on the desk.
Yeah.
This it's like we're looking It's like we're looking through a. I mean, it's kind of like some It's like some trippy kind of Star Trek stuff.
Is.
You know what I mean? When you really think about what's
going
on.
You find it odd at all. These guys love you. They're your fans. They phone Tom
Green. Oh, I think they're calling to talk to you.
No. They phone Tom Green to talk to Tom Green. You know? You think they'd know about this fucking thing unless they loved you? So.
No, I research.
Ah, now nobody cares. I'm just talking general.
Funny, he starts to respond. Yeah, we're all in the room together. It really is strange.
What I find strange is these guys. Like, imagine when you were young, right? And you said, "Hey, I got a chance to talk to David Letterman tonight. Let's phone him, buddies."
I know.
And you talk. You'd be like, "How am I worried?" You know.
Uh-huh.
These guys are like, "Hey, Tom."
Yeah. Well, I mean, but they're.
Hi, Brian.
They're not talking to David Letterman though. They're talking.
They are talking. They're talking to the Chad.
They're talking to the guy who stuck a mouse in his mouth.
We practice.
You know, I mean, you know, they think I'm an idiot, basically. No, they're calling to make fun of me, probably.
No.
No, wait, guys. No,
okay.
I've thinking about that all the time. I know exactly. Imagine if you could have done that, you know, when you were growing up watching, you know, The Tonight Show. Imagine that.
Imagine if you phoned in and they're like, and Ed McMahon and Johnny Carson are looking out, right?
Yeah.
And they're like, hey there, Tom Green from Ottawa?
Yeah.
And Carson's going like, how are you feeling? Worst Carson ever.
Yeah.
But they're interested, you know, you wouldn't be like, hey, Johnny.
No, it'd be awkward, I think.
So you think these kids now have broken
free
to where they can just talk to anybody?
Well, you know, this is also the...
They're looking at each other now.
It's a little bit different now, remember. You guys, the YouTube generation, you know, these guys have cameras, people, you know.
Right, they're just entertaining themselves now.
But we can't talk about them like they're not there, Norm. They're sitting right there. They're not like specimens in some test tube or something. They're right here. We're drinking together tonight.
Yeah. They're drinking.
How's your party? Us,
yeah. How old are you guys?
No.
19.
19 years old. Cool.
19.
Are y'all from Wisconsin?
Yeah.
No, Minnesota, baby. Illinois, Chicago.
Wow.
Chicago.
Good. Hey, guys. Well, thanks for calling in.
Like
That's
it makes
awesome.
Any difference.
We'll check in with you.
Bye.
We're going to check in with you guys later, okay?
Bye, man.
Thanks, man.
You ever meet these guys? Tom, you ever meet these guys? You go like, I'm from Minnesota. You go, where are you from? You from Minnesota, too? Fuck that. I'm from Michigan. What's the difference?
All right, we're gone.
It's another place no one cares about. Why would they be, like, upset? You know what I mean?
What else is going on?
They have a rivalry you have no idea about.
Isn't that neat? Isn't that neat, really, when you think about it? I think that's so neat. And we got the teleprompter now.
Now let's talk about the teleprompter. Can they put anything else in?
Dallas, Texas. Hey, let's take that one.
All right. It's a girl. It says here on the screen, cute girl and guy in Texas. All right.
Yeah.
Wants to get hung up on. Oh, they're on. She's putting on her headphones. Hello.
So she's going to
call. How are you? You're on the air. What's that? Now, that echoey thing is new. What's that echoey thing? What is that thing? That's not good. Is that going out on the Webovision? Are people hearing that? We built this. The studio doesn't always work perfectly. It's a little. Hello, what's your name? We've never met this girl before. What's your name?
Oh,
this is kind of weird to me, actually. I don't want to get rid of them. This is weird. This is just.
That'd be great to hang up on that.
Yeah,
one,
yeah. It actually said she actually said she wanted to get hung up on, but her audio wasn't working.
Oh, anyway.
Like anyone wants to see a baby.
Yeah, I mean we're here. Yeah. You know, it's disgusting.
Yeah, get a little bit.
No. You liked the baby though.
It was cute.
Mm, yeah.
Did you ever see a child get born?
No. Have you?
Yeah, I saw a kid get born. When my kid was being born.
Yeah.
I decided I'd watch it. I would never watch it unless it involved my cum. So I go, I go see my kid getting born. I go, oh, it'll be cool because it's my kid, you know. And then it came out and it was really, really cool, you know. It was like unbelievable, like you loved it and everything.
Yeah.
But you're like sort of hypnotized or something, so you take pictures of the fucking thing. And it looks god awful, like subjectively.
Sure, yeah. Well,
but
I don't know.
You're in this crazy hypnosis where you think it's beautiful. A year later, the child's beautiful. You ever see a one-year-old? Or a
I think it's beautiful at the moment of birth just because of the whole... The whole aura.
It's nice of you, but the magic of it. But if you're not there, you weren't the magic of it. And I go, hey, take a look at this. You go, yeah.
Yeah, I've never experienced that.
Yeah,
one,
it's gonna be your own.
You've never seen it. What are you talking about? You've seen a picture of another person's newborn?
I have seen that.
Not pleasant.
No.
You don't find it pleasant. You don't go, that's beautiful. With blood on it?
Well, no. Yeah. No one's ever showed me a bloody photo.
A bloody infant?
No one's ever shown me a bloody infant photo.
Really?
It's always like a couple minutes. It's like a month after or something.
But they're still,
in a bonnet or something. You know, maybe I just don't have friends that are comfortable enough to show me the bloody photos.
I was that with the bloody ones. A 3-day, 4-year-old, 4-day-old kid. Did you ever see one of those?
Do you carry a bloody photo around, or?
No. We didn't. We didn't tape my bloody infant.
Right.
Because he got cuter later.
Yeah.
No need to
document those early moments.
Thank God, but you said, oh, look, a baby, you know?
Yeah.
It was cute. Yeah.
But do you think childbirth would be cute?
If it was my baby, yes. Just like you said.
Yeah, because you get sort of like hypnotized and shit.
Hypnotized?
Yeah, because, you like the kid because it looks like you a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have children?
No.
Okay. Let's take a call here.
you should have a kid.
We can take calls here, too. I will have one day. I want to have one day. Just, it's difficult, you...
The fun callers.
Find it somebody that you want to, I don't want to get into that.
Why are you taking a caller instead of a TV?
Hello? Well, I just thought it'd be fun every once in a while to go to the sort of terrestrial sort of...
So your choice between a guy with a face and a voice, and you just pick a guy with a voice?
It's just kind of neat that they're there. You know, there's not screen. They're just calling in. Whenever you see a red light, you can just go, hey, where are you calling from?
Texas.
See?
Weird guy. Hey, Texas.
Guy from Texas. That red light's a guy from Texas. Look. Where are you calling from?
He's gone.
Michigan. See? Yeah.
Michigan.
That guy's from Michigan.
That Michigan, that's great, man.
They're mostly prank calls.
Better than that fucking Maven shit.
What?
No, that was an earlier thing.
Oh, okay. I hung up on them because they're mostly prank callers. That's why, that's actually, the prank callers drove us to this thing. We decided, we got to think of a way to get around the prank callers. Oh, I know, if we can see them, they're not going to say some of the stuff that they were saying before on the air. It could be repeated. New York City. We're here, it's 8:47.
New York, you know what's up?
Hanging out with Norm Macdonald in Los Angeles, California.
Hello.
What are you doing?
Hey, Steve, are you going to play another song in a little bit? Maybe after we take a couple calls or, you got some more music in you? Yeah. I'm going to wander out and get a drink, get a breath of fresh air for a second. Hey, how are you? Hey, how you doing?
Hey, I'm good. You?
Good. Where are
Pretty
you?
Good.
You're in New York City, right?
In New York City.
Cool. You're on with Norm Macdonald. Do you want to talk to Norm?
I see him. Yeah. You're a cool guy.
Go ahead. Talk to Norm for a second.
Hi. Well, I can hear my echo in there. That's not good.
This is kind of neat. You're a first-time Skype caller. What we're going to do next week is we're going to set up a thing where everyone can register, and then they're all going to know how it works. They're all going to know how this... we're gonna set them up with good cameras. We're gonna teach the people how it works. They're gonna have good audio, and then we're gonna have about 10, 20 guys a night that we can just go to. But this is the first time we've met, right?
Yeah, pretty much. I've never really used Skype. Like, I've heard of it and everything.
You know what's interesting?
But I've pretty much got Skype because of your thing.
Yeah, I met the other guys before during my morning show, Tom Green, this morning. But what were you gonna say? This guy I've never met
the
before.
Skype, makes it like unbelievable. Like that is. Even though it's infancy, it's on it's a computer on a computer show of us, right? And yet that has better productions than Evening at the Improv.
It's
production values.
It's neat. You know what I think is really neat about too?
What?
Not only do they, cut to him, cut to this man for a second.
He's full screen.
He's full screen on the show.
We're the small screen.
Because, we are, as Time Magazine says, the YouTube generation, right? Aren't we?
Yeah.
Run the prompter there for a second. No.
Is that
hey, so what, you got a skateboard in the background?
Oh yeah, that's my board. Yeah, I'm like a skater.
Are you actually in New York City?
Yeah, I'm 5 minutes away from Manhattan. I live in Astoria, Queens.
Okay, cool. Anyone else in the house right now?
In my house? Yeah, my mom and her boyfriend, but I don't want to talk to them.
Why not?
Because they're gay.
What?
I hope my mom isn't watching this, but I don't.
Can you go get your mom and her boyfriend, or can you go to them, maybe? We talk to them for a second?
I'm in my room, and I don't want to...
Just go grab them. We'll wait.
They're
here.
My mom was like a teacher.
We'll wait. Oh, she'll be good. She'll be sensible. Go get your mother. We'll just sit here and take a call for a second on the hard line here, and you just go
He's
get
scared.
Mom, okay?
Are you going to tell them
I'd be scared, too.
No, I won't say that you called them gay.
They're just acting sometimes.
Yeah, I won't say that. Go get them real quick. He knows. He knows it'll be good. Good evening.
Good evening.
Everyone. President Bush says the troops in Iraq face a learning enemy. An enemy that is learning how to shoot down America. Okay. We gotta get some... What else can you load into that thing? Can you load Huckleberry Finn into that or something? Yeah, can you download that and load it in? Or what? Anything? Bill O'Reilly's scripts? And that's a memo.
Yeah, she doesn't have any clue who you are, and she doesn't know why she wants to talk to you. So I told her, I wanted to see my mom for the show.
She doesn't want to do it.
He's the Chad.
No, she's, laying down, and she's really lazy sometimes.
Okay. You can't go over to her, right? You don't have a wireless?
I have a laptop, but I'm not going to disconnect it because, everything gets all
right. Thanks for playing.
Fuck that guy, right?
Fuck that guy.
He's like, I'm not going to plug the thing in where you have to, and then turn the on thing?
Yeah.
Where
fuck
it gets
that.
Red?
Fuck
back
that guy.
On the couch?
Fuck that guy. No, I mean, we have...
To get on TV? I can
we
get
have,
on TV
we have, we have Tyson in Ohio who wants to do a sake shot, I mean, this guy's just not even getting his mom, just sitting there. Yeah. How's everyone doing tonight, by the way, here? How are you guys all
doing? Hey, everybody.
Yeah, we got a big audience.
This
yeah.
is kind of fun. This is sort of the first time we have a little bit of an audience here tonight. This is kind of
cheers.
Cool.
Cheers.
How are you?
Hey,
what's going on?
How are you?
Oh, really
not
good.
Not much. I got that sake again.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, I remember this guy.
So, do you want to take one?
Yeah, real quick, okay?
Listen.
I remember that guy. We need Hi. Some new material. Julieta from Argentina. Have we gotten her up and running?
We've never had
a video. Oh my gosh, because Julieta tried to get... I've been really hoping to get the camera working with Julieta. We had the audio one day, and we talked, and I felt we had some sort of a connection. But the... Julieta? Oh my God, the video's going to work. Oh my gosh, look at this.
How are you?
How are you doing, Julieta?
Finally.
We meet for the first time.
I know.
How are you doing?
My good. Yes, I'm fine. You know what time is it here now?
What time is it?
It's 1:40 a.m.
Okay, wow. Okay. So you're staying... Okay, you're in Argentina right now. Sorry, I was having a technical issue there. Julieta, we met on the Skype the first day we tried to turn on the Skype. And you, how did you find
What's
out
wrong?
About this?
I know, I was calling.
How did you find out about this?
Is she being held hostage?
Can you listen to me?
I just like that she's in Argentina.
You can hear our voices. You can hear the
Yeah, there's a bit of a delay. Hey, Argentina.
Hey,
Julieta, can you hear us? Is everything okay? Is it working?
The sound is not good.
Sounds not good.
The sound is not good.
Yeah.
Well, Sam is no
yes,
good.
Sam is no good.
Sam is no good or Osama is no good.
Sound.
Salmon salad.
Oh, salmon's no good. Who the fuck like salmon? We can all agree on that.
Salmon salad sandwich.
Salmon salad sandwich.
That's the echo. You hear
the
that?
Echo.
That's the delay.
The echo.
Okay, so, okay, well, we'll figure this out, Juliet.
Bye.
We'll figure this out another time.
Bye.
We're live right now. We got to get people that understand how this works. I really do want to get Juliet up to speed, though, technically.
That's great.
Who's saying hello? Oh, this guy just said hello.
Oh, hello?
I forgot you were there. Where are you?
Tom, it's Andrew from London.
Oh, okay. Oh, from London. Okay, okay, good. I didn't even know you were there. I didn't even know you were from London, Ontario.
All right, London, Ontario.
Is this the guy from the other night who found your watch?
Yes, it is.
Hi,
the hero.
Yes.
The hero.
The guy who found your watch when you crowd surfed into a mosh pit?
Yeah.
The drunken
night. Wow, have you been watching the show, Norm?
Yeah, I watched all the show.
Oh, my gosh. Norm's good.
Oh, that's awesome.
Because I noticed when Angelique got here, you knew Angelique from the show.
I knew her from the television show.
That was cool.
That was cool. That was really cool. It's exciting to know that Norm Macdonald has watched some of the shows here. He actually watches the show. He's seen Tom Green this morning.
Yeah, I love the rainbow, man. Are you showing it? Show some toes.
Awesome.
I have an idea.
That guy's a hero.
I have an idea.
That guy's a hero.
How does he always get through?
Andrew's a hero. Andrew, thanks for calling again.
Why is he a hero?
Honesty. He found my watch and he just mailed it back.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a diamond watch.
That's amazing. A diamond watch?
It was a gift. I did not buy the watch. I'm not the kind of guy that runs out of
watches. He's probably a good guy, but on the other hand, very hard to fence a diamond watch. You know, if one's missing, right?
Yeah, I know.
They report that.
That's true. But, you know, he's still...
He could have kept it.
Yeah, he could have kept it and had a diamond watch.
Or gone and sold it.
Yeah.
And, like, been gone.
Good guy.
Fuck, I hope nobody finds out that's...
Hey, Steve, you want to do a song?
Take one more.
Go up and get in position.
I'll get in position.
We'll take one more call.
Do that.
Get in position. You take a song. Play a song. What looks good here? Funk D in Denver has a few people over watching.
Is he?
Yeah, the ones with a bunch of people are fun.
Brett in Ottawa, Ontario, our hometown. Brent. Oh, this is the... Oh, now he's having a party that we talked to him on Tom Green this morning.
Oh, yeah.
He has a Wi-Fi ability. He walked out. This is the gentleman I told you about who went out on Gladstone.
Oh, I didn't see the gun.
Hello?
Yeah. Hey, how are you?
Tom, how are you doing?
Oh, good. Really good. Good to see you. Brent, how you... Oh, I just lost your video, Brent.
Hang on one second. Can you see me now?
There we go. I got you. This is Brent. Brent this morning.
Wow, look at his hair.
Ron?
Your hair.
We're throwing our show tonight right now, Tom.
Okay, Brent, show us around. Hey, you got a new camera on there, huh?
Tom, what's going on? No, I don't. It's the same camera. We're trying to get... to work here, Tom.
Okay, you're in Ottawa.
We got a bunch of people, though.
Okay, well, this is exciting. In Ottawa, we can't see them. You're pointing at the ceiling. You're pointing the thing at the ceiling.
How's it now? Shut up. How's it now, Tom?
Awesome. Ottawa, Canada. Now, guys, how are you? How are you doing? I'm from Ottawa. Guys, say hello to Norm Macdonald, who also from Ottawa.
Hey, guys.
Norm, listen.
How you doing, man?
Your blazer matches my... Hold up.
Oh, man.
Everyone's going nuts.
This party sounds like that. The hottest thing. This looks like the hottest 50s party ever.
Yeah.
Is this a Super 8 from your childhood?
I don't know. This is Gladstone.
Look at him in his tie.
This is crazy.
This is live?
That's amazing. This is live from Gladstone. Hey, now,
we come from Ottawa, so both Tom and I have hustled many a blowjob on that street.
You've hustled many a blowjob on the street, Tom?
What?
On Gladstone, yeah, just up there behind Songbird Music.
Yeah.
In the alley there.
We have a hooker that works here every day. She's across the street every day. Her name's Ginger.
You remember those days we didn't have much money. We were performers and we had to blow guys that looked like this.
Yeah, just down there behind Songbird Music there in the alley.
Norm, this party is the hottest thing alive.
What the fuck does that mean? Did I have a song that was called The Party Still Alive?
The guy in the hood made me hang up on him.
The guy said, really, you're right, the party does stay alive.
Yeah, no, he said it's the hottest thing alive.
Oh, but he said it as if
But really, it was just four guys sitting around, like, in a room.
Mm-hmm. What the fuck are we?
We got some babes here, we got some babes.
Yeah, at least you got a girl sitting here.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Got a few babes around.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. They're doing the exact same thing we're doing. We should call them back. I feel bad. I'm going to call them back. Calling back Brent in Ottawa. If you want to get on this sort of Skype list, we're going to be creating a registration form this week where you can sign up, get on the list, and then you might get called at any point during the show if you're watching. Bill, you're going to build some sort of thing that allows us to see if they're online. And it'll have a little camera, and it'll say, and then if you're signed up as a correspondent, okay, we're calling Brent back. Sorry, I was just joking around about the guy in the hood. He just...
Show the girls! The guy in the hood is a little drunk. He's drunk right now, Tom.
See, they know I...
There's girls here!
He's defending the guy in the hood.
He's just getting crazy. He's getting crazy,
Tom. Don't. The guy in the hood's a little drunk, you know? It's like they hurt us.
Yeah, I think so.
Hey, Brent. So
yes,
show us around a little bit, and then Steve's going to play a song.
Mm-hmm. Can you see it, Tom?
How you guys doing? Introduce yourselves. Are you guys all students? Do you go to university there? And
Introduce yourselves.
Tom, I'm Greg Quinn. We're broadcasting our own show here called The Show. This is JK.
So we are on their show.
Wait, this is stunning.
We're on their show. There's zero equity in this.
Oh, wait. Oh, hey, how are you? That's was the guy with the hood.
It's a delay. We're on again.
Wait, you guys have a little talk show set there as well that you set up, actually.
Yeah.
Brent showed it to me earlier today.
We're trying to get this camera working on Skype.
That's
right
a nice
now.
Looking camera you got there.
It's hard. Yeah, it's good.
A good camera. All right, Brent.
The girls don't believe we're on.
Oh, there are girls.
We're on
there
right
are
now.
Girls.
Oh, hello. There's girls from Ottawa. They were just saying we don't want to be seen on this thing. Don't point it at us. We have lives. We have lives. We don't want to be seen on the national Webovision. All right, cool. Okay, guys, we got it. Okay.
Why is it whenever it goes to that red table, it looks like post-war Berlin? Everything else is kind of modern.
Yeah. But I think those guys are going to have a lot of potential as Wi-Fi correspondents in the future.
I didn't know they were. Are they Wi-Fi correspondents, or that's what they would like to be?
Well, they actually are now. They are.
That was what that fucking thing was. We just did.
Yeah.
That's the idea behind that was. I thought it was just a phone call. That was a planned thing you guys did.
No, it wasn't planned. No.
Oh, I thought you thought that was a good idea.
No.
Like you were trying out like...
No. We're just working on the technical side first. We're not at the idea part yet.
I got you.
We're not at the actual...
I didn't know that.
We're just trying to get the camera
story. I thought, who knows? You worked for a week on it. You thought it was like some Bob and Ray thing.
No.
And I was like, what?
No.
I didn't understand.
No, we didn't script that.
No, okay.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Cue the guy in the hood. No. No. I wish we had, though, actually. And it was just this horror... No.
Yeah.
No, okay, wait, who have we not talked to? One more and then you'll play a quick song.
Please.
What do you think?
One more, please.
Yeah, how are you doing
the
tonight?
People want it fantastic.
Yeah?
You going in soon?
No.
Okay, let's... How about you play one quick song? Play one quick song. What are you going to play for us? I think I need to go refresh my drink here.
Some refresher.
Yeah, let's go freshen
like
up a drink.
Play after dinner.
Yeah. 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 Steve, why don't you play some music for us? Yeah.
Who don't like me?
No.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
All right, I'm bald.
No.
That's right.
No, Steve.
It's all good.
No, it's okay.
No, hey, but those people, you can go take a break.
Yeah.
And everyone else, want to hear a song?
It's your fault.
I'm going to sing one. It's called American Car. It goes like this. Oh, wait a second. I'm not going to sing yet because I got to tune my guitar. So, think we're good. Let's go to... All right, I guess this will work. Close enough for WebOvision. Whoa, what's that? Okay. Heavy artillery. My life's a wreck and so is my car. I want to tell you, I'm just not happy with the way things are. I want to tell you, I'm going in fast and I'm going in hard. Gonna be driving my American car. Four ball tires, every fluid low. Engine's on fire, but you'll never make me leave the road.
Is that not working?
My head is spinning and so are my wheels. I want to tell you, Betsy Ross is on my lap and I'm copping a feel. I want to tell you, 2 tons of steel flying over the tar. 2 miles a gallon, my American car. 4 ball tires, every fluid low. Engine's on fire, but you'll never make me leave the road. Zigga wow, zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow wow wow. Zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow wow wow. Where would we be without a car? It's who I am, it's who we are. What will happen when the oil runs dry? No more pieces of American pie. Well, we're headed for a cliff and we ain't got no brakes. I think this joyride was a big mistake. What do they know? The lights have changed and so's my luck. I want to tell you, the cops are on my tail, but I don't give a fuck. I want to tell you, 2 tons of steel flying over the tar. 2 miles a gallon, my American car. 4 ball tires, every fluid low. Engine's on fire, but you'll never make me leave. No, you'll never make me leave the road. Zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow wow wow. Zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow wow wow. Zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow, zigga zigga wow wow. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Of course, I'm being abandoned here on the WebOvision. Much here enjoyment. Thank you, Internet. Okay, now this song is called Anyone, Anywhere, Anywhere. It goes like this. It goes, I went down to the local store. Well, I grabbed my things and I shut the door. And something like that, but I kind of forgot it. So I'm going to try again. It's hard to play. It's very simple. What? I went down to the local store. Well, I grabbed my things and I shut the door. And I want things to be like they were before. And I went down to the local bar. Well, I jumped in my keys and I grabbed my car. And I didn't have to travel very far to know that I don't know anyone anywhere anymore. I don't know anyone anywhere anymore. Is it everything still looks the same, but I have changed? Or is it nothing seems to look the same, but I have changed? I don't know anyone anywhere anymore. I said, I don't know. Thank you. I have changed. Or is it nothing seems to look the same, but I haven't changed? Or is it everything still looks the same, but I have changed? I don't know anyone anywhere anymore. I don't know anyone anywhere anymore. All right, okay, I'm winded again. Thank you, Webber.
Now wait, Steve, that was awesome. Wait, just stay there for a second, Steve. You mind? You have a drink and everything?
Fuck, man.
We I'm getting one.
That's cool. Wait, we got
we both have red drinks.
Yeah, we went and got another...
I was doing this whole fucking thing without a mic?
No, no, don't. No, no, we... No, we... We had the mics on earlier. We have to... Are the mics working, Bill?
Yeah.
Yeah? Welcome back.
Guy decides to ask that 38 minutes into the show.
No, no. We took them off right before we went. I said, oh, yeah, remember, I said, do you
well,
want
that's
to?
That's good.
Yeah. Because we wanted to go talk about that stuff.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
Who knows we didn't
what
want...
the fuck that was.
Yeah.
It was like, remember in the early days of satellites and shit, if a guy had a big satellite, and then you hear what the guys would say between the newsmen and shit. You
right.
Know?
Oh.
So they do their news, and then they go, hey, Carol, you got a sandwich? Yeah, and they just talk like normal.
Where
shit.
Would you hear that? On
you never heard that?
No, I never. You had a satellite.
If you had a satellite
oh,
dish.
Yeah.
In
oh,
the
did
old
you
days,
have a satellite dish in
no,
old days?
No, but I heard about oh. it. You get a big satellite.
I never
dish.
Heard the sandwich.
And
stuff.
Then so you would watch NBC, and it'd be Brian Gumbel and a guy doing a baseball game. Then they go to commercial, and the guy would go, "Hey, Brian, man, how are you doing? How's your golf game?" And
yeah.
Go, pretty good. We're coming back soon.
That's basically what we do every night here for an hour.
I know,
just
exactly.
How, got a sandwich? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like the stuff that's not on the air.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Now, do you want to talk to the kids?
Yeah, sure.
Sam's coming in.
Sam, you want to talk? You
yeah, why not?
Come have a seat. We
have. Thank
somebody's you for coming.
Got to, mic it.
Yeah, it was grab
no,
that
no,
mic right
got,
there.
Oh,
just pin that on. Sam.
I didn't get the name.
Hey, Sam Simon. Hey, Norm. How are you? You know, I used to have that dish.
Yeah?
That Norm was talking.
Let me introduce you to everyone here. Sam Simon. You invented The Simpsons?
No, I made The Simpsons.
You started it.
TV series.
You started the whole thing.
Yeah.
You were the main...
Tracy Ullman show. I was executive producer of the Tracy.
You were the main creative
no, I was
force
one of the,
behind
the,
it.
I was one of the yeah, people was, that made it into
him
show.
And Jim Brooks.
Yeah.
And Matt Green.
So you started that on
but
the Tracy Ullman show.
I wrote a fucking cartoon because I used to read it before The Simpsons. It was in a little comic book and shit.
Uh-huh. That was,
and it was like...
That was Life in Hell. That
Life in
the
Hell,
Simpsons.
Yeah. So it was like... Fucking it was like in this alternative paper in L.A., right? So there'd be like... You know how you have a cartoon, you have some captions?
Uh-huh.
They'd have about 30 or 40.
Right.
You know? And little things... Nothing would happen, you know? It was all like not funny at all. And then that was Matt Groening. And it was called Life in Hell. It didn't have anything to do with
yeah.
hell. And
yeah.
it just went on
well,
forever.
Unlike
and
Norm,
never
I'm a fan
once.
Of Life in
you never
Hell.
Laughed
and
once.
I think it was more than what.
So,
what.
So
you must
okay.
be friends
Norm
with Matt. Matt. You must
so
be
you're
friends
saying
with
Life
Matt.
In Hell was funny. You laughed at it.
Yeah, I thought it
name
was.
Name me one what? Good Life in Hell.
This is Matt Groening.
Akbar and Jeff yeah. were talking about their homosexuality and... I don't remember the rest of it, but it was very funny.
This was a funny episode.
Well, there's proof right there.
There was a funny one.
You have his word on it.
Yeah.
He'd sign an affidavit. He doesn't remember any of the funny part of it.
Norm.
Well, you're putting him in a, you're putting
a
him on the
name
spot
a funny
here.
Peanut.
A funny peanut?
Yeah, which one?
Peanuts.
Name it.
Peanuts was really
name
funny.
It. Yeah, I know it was, but what's a funny one? What happened?
Oh, so you're saying it's that low, like a...
Low?
Low.
That's the high bar.
Snoopy, when Snoopy was
there you go.
On the fly in the
same thing
the Linus
said. Yeah,
the dirt bag kid with the dust. That was one.
Pigpen.
Right.
Oh, Pigpen.
Pigpen, yeah.
I got it.
That's not a strip,
right.
That's a character. What
so wait,
I said
tell us how,
I talked
tell,
about
tell, tell the people
one.
That let's not argue about this here. I mean
yeah.
you're putting
this
the poor
ugly,
guy in the
Norm.
Spot.
Why do you have to turn everything so make it so negative?
I consider myself your friend.
Yeah. The Simpsons attacked me.
Do you consider yourself
personally.
My friend? They did.
The Simpsons.
Well, I had nothing to do with that.
The, Sim- The Simpsons. I consider you.
Television show.
I'm proud to have you here.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you consider yourself.
Absolutely, yeah. If, I mean, I'm honored to be your friend.
Consider yourself what?
Yeah, you know, I said you consider yourself. This is what just happened on fucking WeboVision.
No, I'm just trying to keep the thing moving.
You
along.
Consider myself a friend. You consider ourselves friends. And then he said, "The Simpsons was good. Must have made a lot of money." And I'm like sitting there going, "No, I asked a human question."
No, I didn't. I didn't. No.
Wait, when I said, what did he say? I didn't realize that.
No, it's because I cut Norm off because I was trying to, because, you know, Sam's here now.
Yeah, okay.
I'm just here for,
I'm a spice.
No, I know.
I'm a spice. I just sprinkle me in. This is your star here, man.
You're right.
Don't you have a trialogue?
You're right. I should have, it's a lot going on. It's a lot going on. Now, you've been sitting over here. You're a guy that's been around comedy.
I wasn't drinking this rocket fuel that you guys seem to...
Why don't you drink something?
Here, I'll have some. There's somebody else's is here.
Because, listen, Sam can drink a lot more than me, and you can drink a lot more than me. I can't drink a lot of booze.
Yeah.
So, you guys got the advantage.
Yeah. We don't have to drink a lot more, although we could have a shot, maybe. Quick shot. You guys want to do a shot, maybe? Shot of Jägermeister? Yeah. Remember we had that Jägermeister last time?
Oh, I was watching that.
Yeah.
I would like to try that.
We could do a shot of that.
I would. Maybe
with these guys on Skype. There's a guy in Virginia that always
we
does
can
a shot
drink
with
guys from
James,
the team from the internet.
Oh, let's do a shot with the University of Wisconsin.
We have a sports question in reference to your hat from Boston.
Show your shirt, though.
Because you have a Yankees shirt in Boston. He's noticed it.
That's a walking contradiction.
Yeah, he has a question about that. Wrong to be Yankees and Red Sox fan, question mark.
Yeah, how you guys doing?
Hey, Brian, we're just waiting to see if you can flick your camera on there. I don't know if you can. There we go. It's coming on. Yeah, we got to figure out how to get those to pop up quicker. How are you, Brian?
Good. How you doing?
Good. You have a sports related question for Norm.
They look like they're in this space.
Oh, yeah. I got a question for Norm actually.
Yeah.
Norm, I and my family was pretty much halfway split, Red Sox and Yankees, and I don't know. A lot of my friends. Fans, and then half of my family was Red Sox fans. Plus, I've always only liked watching Yankees and the Red Sox because that's what I've always been really into. So I don't know. I just wanted to ask you,
you gotta get a new mic. It's like we're talking to an astronaut or something.
That's what it looks like to me.
But he's talking about the Yankees. Thank you. Your mic's not working. But he's talking about the Yankees and the. Yeah, you're a fan of both teams.
Well, but Norm's wearing.
What?
He's got Yankees and Red Sox.
Aren't they competitive?
The Trojans and the Spartans.
I got a Yankees hat, and I got this. I got a Red Sox sweatshirt.
Yeah.
And I don't go by, what team I like or any of that fucking horse shit.
Yeah. You know?
I find the team that makes the best sweatshirt turns out to be Yankees.
Yeah.
I look, who makes the best hat?
Right.
These guys, Boston.
Wow.
So I have all kinds of shit.
Canadians, I mean, did you follow baseball in Canada?
The Expos. Montreal Expos. And there was a guy, Rusty Staub. Everybody's hero when he was a kid.
Le Grand Orange.
And Le Grand Orange, yeah. And he was my hero when I was a kid. You know, I wanted to be like Rusty Staub. And years later, I met Montreal Expos pitcher. Who was the guy that was like crazy?
Oh, I remember the catcher was...
No, he wasn't a catcher. He was the pitcher.
The crazy guy, huh?
Yeah.
The cocaine guy?
No.
Steve Howe.
Tim Rock did cocaine.
Okay, yeah.
But he did, he was a pitcher named Bill Lee.
Oh, okay, Bill Lee.
And he smoked
Bill
pot.
Lee, the... Oh, yeah, Rocket
Eccentric,
Man or something?
Yeah, exactly.
No? Bill Lee was crazy?
Yeah.
No more Jaeger. How's that possible? Did I drink it all this morning?
At the beginning of the show, that thing was full. I was backstage. I was just kidding that I didn't have
it. Is that back? Or? Oh, really? Well, get another type of shot. Tequila, yeah. That'll be good.
What do you drink? Tequila? Do you drink tequila?
I tasted Jägermeister. That young man told me that there's codeine in it.
Are you allergic?
That's what he said.
Are you allergic?
Not allergic.
Maybe do a shot of tequila.
Well, I'll do whatever you want. I'm a sport.
So wait, can you talk to some people about The Simpsons if people
sure.
call in? Hey!
Hey, Tom!
This is Zach in Sacramento.
It's Sack and Zach.
I'm sorry, I got busy.
Got a little music going on there.
Got a little distracted.
How you doing, Zach?
Very good. How you doing, sir?
Good. What's going on? How you doing tonight?
I heard you guys talking about Jägermeister.
Yes. Yeah. We're out of Jägermeister, but we do have tequila.
You have tequila?
Yeah. If you'd like to do a shot with us, as I saw.
Absolutely.
On your Skype window. I saw that you wanted to do a shot.
Can you hear the beats?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Now, what are you doing in Sacramento tonight? What's your story? What's going on today with you?
Well, I basically tried to get Chris Daughtry to do a promo for the channel last night.
That's the guy from American Idol, right?
You're correct. And he wasn't having any of it.
Radio this morning.
He was, I guess, anti the channel.
He's a big, he's got a big record out. You must be a big Chris Daughtry fan, just judging on by the haircut.
No. He actually played at the club I work at last night.
He's the bald guy.
Is he the bald guy that, that was Tony?
You look like him a little bit.
No, I actually heard that a lot last night. That actually got me.
Hey, who loves you, baby?
Aha! Actually, Tom, I wanted to ask you something. Do you think you might have contributed to Andy Dick's demise with the whole Jimmy Kimmel thing?
Is Andy Dick dead?
No. That was not a demise at all. That was a fun bit. I saw that on YouTube. There's a big video going around because Andy Dick got kicked off the Jimmy Kimmel show. Yeah. But no, it looked like it was all in good fun to me.
You think it was all a bit?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it was all a bit. Hey, why don't you talk to Crocker?
Andy
Dick. Hey, can I tell you about the
fucking... What a fucking Telly Savalas.
Can I tell you about the fucking funniest pilot, which was that show?
Telly Savalas?
Yeah.
Kojak?
Yeah. It's called the Marcus Nelson Murders, right? You want to hear about
it? Oh, I saw that.
It had the funniest goddamn line ever in a television show. Oh, you going to have a drink?
Well, we got our shot here.
I know, but only you do.
Norm's driving me, so...
I don't drink tequila. Let me just drink the green thing. I don't think you have
Norm's
my best drunk. Interest at heart now. You were supposed
drink
to
drink the green thing.
Your Norm's got a lift. But...
I don't Norm's drink.
Not, Norm's not really driving.
Can you see, like.
No, I don't drive. I'm not driving.
Okay,
I don't drive
the green
or
thing.
Drink.
The green thing.
Cheers.
The green thing. Thank you, Tom.
Cheers.
It's red, Norm.
Yeah, I know it's red.
He's just having a.
Wait, who else?
What was the funny line in the?
How you guys
coach
having fun?
Yeah, no, he doesn't even remember.
You want to have a seat here?
He's the host that doesn't listen.
No, I'm listening.
No, he's listening.
He listened and he reminded
you're out of control.
What happened? What were we talking about? I forgot.
He was talking
I wasn't
about
paying
some
attention.
Line in the Marcus Nelson.
The Marcus Nelson murders.
Which was the pilot for Kojak.
The pilot for Kojak.
He says the funniest line in a TV
and
show
have you ever.
Have
you ever seen Kojak?
I have. I
then
do. Telly Savalas.
You know Crocker that Kevin Dobson played.
You know, it's a little. I don't remember Crocker.
Crocker was young. Kojak was the.
Oh, he was kind of grizzled.
Yeah, he was grizzled.
Seen it all.
Exactly. He'd seen
Crocker
it all.
Crocker was young. Oh, let's.
So in Marcus Nelson Murders, it was Crocker's first case.
Okay.
Right. And he was green.
Uh-huh. Right. Oh, really?
Yeah, he was green.
Oh, that's why you said the green.
First case, yeah.
He was green and Kojak knew it.
Right, he was.
So Marcus Nelson was these murders that were happening in L.A. So they sent out Crocker and
Kojak.
Kojak says to him, "Crocker, go interview the ladies. All these hookers were getting killed."
Right, sure.
Go this interview escorts. You know,
the pilot for Kojak.
The pilot for Kojak. Marcus Nelson. Yeah. Crocker, it's your first case.
This is Telly Savalas' imitation.
Yeah. Crocker, it's your first case. You go get, go find out if this latest girl that's dead. I want you to talk to her parents, a mother.
Yeah.
You know? So Crocker goes, "All right, I'll do it. It's my first case, you know." And then he leaves, and they go, and then he goes, "I think he's green, you know." So he shows up at the lady's house, and then he comes back, and he goes, "Hey, Kojak." He goes,
it must be funny.
He goes, "Kojak, I think we made a mistake. This girl that was killed, she wasn't a hooker like all the others. I talked to her mother.
Right.
She was a nice, nice girl, you know, real American."
This is the,
yeah. So then Kojak goes, "Oh, yeah. He takes a sucker, you know, because he has seen it all."
Right.
And
just
and,
another
yeah,
and Crocker, lick of the lollipop for him.
And Crocker's green as grass.
He's wide as.
So he goes, "Oh, yeah, Crocker. She was a good girl," you know, because that's what he told him. He goes, "I talked to the mother. She was a good girl. You know, she wasn't a prostitute. She was a good girl. He goes, yeah, yeah, she was a good girl. Mama's apple pie, the 4th of July. She was a hooker!
This is Savalas, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Savalas.
Yeah, she was a good girl.
She was
Mama's
a good girl.
Mama's apple pie, 4th of July. She was a hooker.
She was a good girl. She was a Mama's apple pie, 4th of July. She was a hooker!
She was a good girl. Good girl, she was.
Tell us about the Columbo pilot.
4th of July.
She was a good girl. Mama's apple pie. 4th of July. She was a hooker! Like that? No, yeah. No.
He said it for his own
you
good.
You did it much better.
He said it for his own good because fucking.
She's Crocker. A hooker, yeah. I get nervous doing
it. Crocker had to grow up. You did it good.
How do you know this?
I like TV.
You do, huh? Do you, but was Kojak one of the big shows for you growing up?
Every television show.
What were your favorite shows then?
When I was young, Kojak and Beretta.
Columbo. Uh-huh.
And Columbo was great, yeah.
Columbo was awesome.
What about you? What do you like? But my favorite show is that Bugs Bunny.
Oh, yeah? For sure. That's a good one.
That was the best.
Looney Tunes.
Yeah. Do the from the Bugs Bunny pilot.
I can't do it, but you can do it.
What?
You can do it. This guy's you ever hear of Mel Blanc?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
This guy makes fucking Mel Blanc look like Fred Travellina. Listen to this fucker. Any guy, Foghorn Leghorn, anybody.
Any voice.
Name
any
a character. From the Warner Brothers cartoon.
Or you could create a character and you know,
or you can say like it's
one.
A dog, but he's sophisticated.
All right, Bugs Bunny. Let's make sure we have our cameras here. And yeah, Bugs Bunny, we're
it's
all
a very
set
good
up.
Start.
And what's up, Doc?
No, he can actually do Bugs Bunny. I don't know.
That was actually pretty good.
No, can I tell you something? He can actually do Bugs Bunny. Well, he turns into Andy Kaufman when he can do the impression. He can do Bugs Bunny. I've seen him do it.
Oh, I'm sure.
Ask him one more time.
I can do Andy Kaufman.
Ask him one more time.
Bugs Bunny.
He'll
come on.
Do it.
Let's do it, Sam.
Hey, I'll do.
It's nobody watching.
I'll do Bugs Bunny.
Yeah. What's up, Doc?
That's me actually doing
that's
my best Bugs Bunny.
Oh, that's a good impression.
Yeah. How now have you been doing? When did you start doing voices?
I've never done voices. It's just it's just him. You know, in our conversations, these things come up. So
you do impressions, though.
Oh man, give me one. Are you kidding?
Can you do Burt Reynolds?
I can do Jimmy Cagney or John Stewart.
Do Jimmy Stewart.
Do John Stewart as the guy in Harvey.
I can do Jimmy Stewart, but I don't know what he says in movies and stuff.
Yeah.
But I remember on The Tonight Show, I loved Jimmy Stewart because he came into the show with a poem about how
his dog
was dead.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
Yeah. Dog named Bo.
You know that song?
No.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Uh-huh, I'm not fucking kidding you.
Can you put it on YouTube? I've seen
that, and it's really touching, actually.
It's
yeah.
Incredible.
Yeah, he tells a poem, and he tears up about
his
dog.
I do it?
Yeah.
What, like I do a one-man show of
or
Jimmy
you can
Stewart
recite
doing
a poem
that poem?
It's funny that you say that. I was actually thinking about that today, because I was, not to be, I was lying down with my dog today, and I was with Annie.
Did you get up with fleas?
What's the Canadian expression? This is very interesting. You say lying down with your dog. What do they say in Canada?
Fucking your dog.
They do, right?
Yeah, they say you fuck the dog in Canada, but here you lie down with the dog.
But talk about this expression in Canada. What does fuck the dog mean?
I'm taking the day off work, I think.
I'm fucking the dog today.
Skip school or
I'm
something.
I'm skipping school. I'm taking the day off work. You ever try this in the United States?
Fucking the dog, no, you get arrested, yeah. Homeland
Have
Security.
You ever said it? I'm honest.
I fuck the dog? No. Yeah.
People don't understand it in the United States.
No.
Because I said that.
That's
many
true,
people,
yeah. I fuck the dog.
Because I grew up my
the...
whole life saying if I want to say I'm not doing anything today, I go, I'm just fucking the dog. And everyone I know understands it.
Yeah.
Then I move to a foreign country, right? And the guy says, what are you doing today? And I go, I don't know, I'm just fucking the dog. And the guy goes, you're fucking the dog? And I go, yeah, I like to fuck the dog. Thinking that ever, you don't know,
Yeah, you're on phone with like a plumber or something like that.
First day in L.A.
Yeah.
You know, and you're a guy who likes to say fuck the dog a lot.
It's funny when you move from Canada to, I mean, I just moved here 7 or 8 years ago. But when you move
here.
That's
about when I moved, yeah.
People start, you don't realize all the things you say. Like, you say A, I said A, and people kind of call you on it.
When I
first moved to New York City.
That's not like fuck the dog.
It's not like fuck the dog.
Yeah, you don't know that. You're an American.
No, you've been telling me it for years. And I just go, like, fine, I'll leave you alone.
You actually thought he was off fucking a dog somewhere.
Of course. They go, what? And you know,
he's going like, you say A,
but
you
I
say
tell you,
boot.
It's funny, because usually in Canada, this is the expression, right? You go, hey, what are you doing today? I'm fucking the dog. Oh, cool, man. That's really, you're lucky, man. Yeah, you know, you want to come over and fuck the dog? Then you get to America. Right? And the guy's like, hey, what are you doing today? You go, I'm fucking the dog. And the guy goes, you're fucking the dog? And you go, yeah, man, why don't you come over and fuck the dog with me? And the guy goes, no, I don't want to fuck the dog with you. And I go, what's with this fucking guy? You know, he gets to fuck the dog and he doesn't
want
to fuck the dog.
And what if I said that and then I was saying, like,
did it take a while before you realized that this was sort of just a communication gap and that you'd actually.
Oh, yeah, man. Well, it took not long. It took about an hour and a half.
Yeah.
What if I were dog sitting, and I called you and I said what are you doing? You said I'm fucking the dog, and I said you want to come over and fuck the dog with me? And I go, well, I'm taking care of somebody's dog today. Would you say, well, just bring the dog over?
No, and then it would have been all out in the open. Then he would have said we'd have misunderstood.
We wouldn't be on the same
page.
Well, no, I don't. I mean, I don't blame the Americans at all because
we, the Canadians,
came up with it. We said, "Hey,
how did
man,
we get onto this dog fucking thing?" And we were telling a nice story about James. The dog named Bo, and I was lying down with Annie earlier today, and I was cuddling with her, and I was saying, "God, I really love this dog a lot, you know." And I was, boy, it's going to be sad when she's gone. And then I thought, you know, boy, what? Remember when
old Bo?
Yeah.
Hey, do the old Bo thing for him.
Well, I don't even know. I don't know that poem.
That's exactly what it is.
I used to have a dog or whatever the fuck he said.
Go ahead. Anybody can do Jimmy. No, and I'm not putting it down as imitation, but it's
no,
like,
I can't do.
What you were doing? Yes, you were doing.
I was.
You guys do like Lance Bass?
Name a Bo. Who's it? Lance Bass? An impression of him?
He's one of the. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up, Tom?
Where are you calling from?
Indianapolis.
Oh, wow, look at that.
Hey, congratulations.
Hey, man, congratulations on that shit city you live in. Hey, good thing with the football team, though, man. They did good.
Yeah.
That's all we got. But I got a question for Norm.
Go ahead.
I read on the internet that he used to write for Roseanne.
Yeah? Something I've known for years.
Well, Norm, was it your idea to have Roseanne work in a restaurant that sells loose meat sandwiches?
No.
Do you remember that bit?
Yep.
You do?
Yeah, some other guy figured that.
Yeah. What was that?
You know, probably on the whole, 6 years or whatever Roseanne was on, I, you know, probably had a couple of things that got on.
It's
so the chance that the loose meat would
How many writers are there?
I don't know.
That was your first, like, Hollywood 20? Gig, was it? Or
no, I wrote for the Dennis Miller Show.
Oh, cool.
It was a talk show.
Yeah, I remember, yeah. Yeah.
Well, you wrote for Dennis Miller before you did the SNL?
Isn't that funny?
SNL?
That Yeah.
Yeah, it was funny.
Because you,
that's
and then
weird.
You did Weekend Update, and yeah.
No, this is how it happened. Is Dennis Miller, like, he was like, hey, man, I heard from this guy. This guy was talking to another guy, and he was like, hey, Dennis Miller likes this one joke. Like, he heard a comic say it in New York, and this comic, the rest of his act is pure shit. But this one joke was really good, and Dennis liked it, you know? And then he told the story, and I was like, hey, man, that's my fucking joke, you know? And so I couldn't figure if some guy stole my joke,
right?
And then he had a bunch of other shit
jokes. What joke was it?
Or that it was me, and I had my other jokes were all shit.
Oh, yeah.
So,
but it was someone stole your joke,
yeah,
for sure.
So I came up, and I said, no, that was mine, you know? And then Dennis Miller gave me a job. I had to, but he had to write jokes about the news.
Yeah.
And so my manager, Howard Lapidus, your manager now, he told me, Norm, man, they want some jokes about the news. And so I never read the newspaper or shit, you know, so I'm reading and can't think of a fucking joke, you know?
Right, right.
Because most of the stuff I don't even understand is about the economy. And
but you read the news now because we were you seem to be pretty up.
I can understand, like, the news I understand.
You seem like a news junkie.
A lady kills herself. I can understand that, you know what I mean? But I don't understand the economy and all that shit.
Yeah, well, that's...
So I'm reading the fucking newspaper, and I'm like, who the fuck is this lady, you know? It didn't lend itself to jokes when I didn't know anything. So I wrote... Anyways, you're supposed to
send... sound like you're reading the section of the paper that lends itself to world news or national.
No. I tried for this to write this thing.
Right.
But since I'm so...
It was very latest news. This is the... Yeah.
So Howard said, you know, they want 40 jokes, and I couldn't think... Ew. 40, I can only think of one. So I said, I said, there's no use putting like 39 like bad jokes in one. I'll just send the one.
Right.
And then so I sent the one, and then he gave me the job from there.
Yeah, that's cool.
What was the joke?
It wasn't very funny.
It must have been good.
No, it was the first day of the
Watergate.
Dennis, who's the guy that killed all the people in Cleveland?
Cleveland.
Not Cleveland. It wasn't Cleveland. Jeffrey Dahmer.
Dahmer, yeah. Okay,
Wasn't it Cleveland?
You said Dennis.
Yeah.
Jeffrey Dahmer, yeah.
Yeah, what Jeffrey Dahmer.
Where was he?
Wisconsin.
Yeah. Oof. So anyways, the joke was he was up for a trial, and his defense, I thought, was a little shaky. they started it.
Wow.
That was the joke you sent?
Yeah, so I just went and sent one joke. And then
that was one you didn't want 39 bad ones?
So you sent, like,
said,
crazy kind of almost like an anti-joke joke.
Yeah, well, I don't know if it's anti-joke. I mean, I think technically it's a
but,
joke.
I mean, it's a weird joke as a one joke to send. But obviously you cut through all...
Let me ask you a question. Here's an interesting question for
you. Did he perform it?
You guys are comedy experts.
Did he perform it?
No.
What?
Did Dennis Miller do that joke?
Yes, and later on, it didn't do that.
Hisses?
Didn't do very well, yeah. Kind of. But you guys are both comedy experts, here's an interesting joke. Here's an interesting idea. What's the first joke you can? What's the most elementary? What's the most elementary joke that for a child?
Why is the chicken cross the road?
Why is the chicken cross the road? Uh-huh. Right. And when you think about it, the answer is to get to the other side.
Yeah.
Right.
That's an anti-joke.
It's an anti-joke. Isn't that interesting that the first joke you learn is an anti-joke?
Yeah.
You have no context for that joke to be funny.
Yeah.
You'd have had to heard cross the chicken jokes where there was like a pun or something at the end. You know what I mean?
Right. Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah. I always found that interesting.
Well, I don't know if that's really, the first joke you really hear, but...
really interesting.
Right? John Schwartzwelder, you've seen
weird,
his name
actually,
on The Simpsons.
Far too interesting for the...
Over and over, and I hired him because
the kids understand.
Yeah, you think the kids understand? No, it's really interesting because it's like your first joke you learn is making fun of the whole concept of jokes to begin with.
Yeah,
it's not your first.
It's like
joke.
How can you be making fun of that? You haven't even heard a joke yet, right?
He's right.
Here's your first joke.
Yeah. Funny faces.
Yeah, that joke never had legs.
Yeah. Funny faces, yeah.
It's funny for the first few months.
Right. Now, I've been stuck making funny
There's
faces.
There's a writer named John Schwartzwelder that I hired on The Simpsons. He's written, I think, 60 episodes of the show. He's been on the show for 18 years. And I hired him because he did a cartoon in a magazine that I saw. And it was a chicken that had been run over, and another chicken was on its knees going, "Why? Why?" So,
right. Yeah, yeah. No, I mean, yeah.
No?
Yes, I get it completely.
That's funny, right? Okay. Well,
we should drink some more booze, right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Well, it's a party, isn't that virtually
any? It's not really.
All
like
that a party
actually,
about.
What I want to do. No, I mean, this has been awesome. It was fun to know.
Because when I hear about parties, Tom, I go, you know, it's people drinking booze,
yeah,
and then every once in a while they talk.
Yeah, let's drink some booze. Let's drink some booze. No, absolutely, absolutely.
What?
This was, I mean...
Too much talking, not enough drinking.
Too much talking, not enough drinking?
I don't think the show will be better.
Hey, we have a question.
No.
This is awesome. Cheers.
It's a Tom Green show.
Cheers.
Instead of talking heads, it's drinking heads. The most boring thing ever.
There you go.
All right. So what is this? This is tequila, which I don't drink.
What do you mean? Have you ever had it?
Do we have anything else? Do we have anything Jack Daniels? Do you drink that?
Sure.
Something
Hey, he's my ride home.
Just go bring everything out here. We'll see what we got. Okay, wait a minute. Let's take a couple of more Skype calls, and then Steve, you want
to
play?
Can I say something to you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Before
this is not the forum for you to speak.
We can talk as much.
Can I say this, that I went to a
Expos game?
Tom, listen. Look at me. I went to a Chinese restaurant, to a Chinese bar, you know.
Yeah.
A Chinese bar.
And I said to the guy, Tom, you know, I like to drink. You know that.
A Chinese bar.
Yeah. You're kind of
here in Los
Angeles.
You're kind of
my mentor with drinking, right?
I don't really think that's true.
So you want to see me drink at all. Bar. So I go to the bar and I say to the, it's a Chinese bar.
2:30?
You know, I like Chinese bar.
Yeah.
So I say to the guy, give me a stoli with a twist. Right?
Oh, no.
So he says to me,
you better,
he
this
says,
is like,
all right
like,
then.
Stop cameras.
Once racist. Upon a time, there were four bears.
Max. Are you watching this? Tell Max this story. Tell Max this story.
What the say? I just fucking told you.
Start it again with him.
You want me to do that thing twice in a row? It doesn't make any sense.
No,
you,
but you know what?
You do
he didn't hear it.
You didn't hear
he
it?
He didn't hear it. Start again.
It's just a picture on the computer.
Hey, Norm, you said
no,
it
was
a
real guy.
Listen,
I was excluding you. Okay, good.
So, what's
because of the Chinese thing?
What is this cat's name?
Yeah, it's kind of a stereotype.
We do Chinese jokes.
No, it has nothing to do with China. What's the cat's name?
It has nothing to do with Chinese.
Max, right?
Yeah. Max.
Yeah, you're Max, on Norm. Norm,
Max. Norm this wants is to... Norm Macdonald.
Yeah, Norm.
Max, so a fella.
What's that, Norm?
Hey, buddy, man. A fella I heard about, he goes to a Chinese, what is it?
Chinese restaurant.
Yeah,
no,
Chinese.
No, you gotta tell it yourself.
I mean, a Chinese bar.
He goes to a bar and there's a Chinese
bar. The guy goes to a Chinese bar and the fella, the patron asks him, what was it?
I want a soli with a twist.
Yeah, he goes, hey, the Chinese guy goes, hey man, what you want? What you want? What you want?
There you go.
And then he's like, I'm gonna have a, you know, give me a soli with a twist.
Right.
So the guy goes, okay, man, I give you a story with a twist. Once upon a time, there were four bears. Okay.
Okay. Let me explain. There's an old cliche.
The
guys would say L's instead of R's and reverse.
That's not his problem. He's not familiar with ASOC.
No one has any idea what you're talking about.
He's not the right audience.
So instead of Stoli, it's story. And so instead of three bears, story with a twist, there are four bears. Even Tom just found out what you were talking about. Right?
Wow.
I just enjoy.
You just understood what I said, right?
I thought you were bringing other booze. What's this?
Yeah, we're bringing other booze.
But until I explained it, you didn't know what he meant, right?
Yeah, sure.
Tom, what else do we got?
Tom.
Why do you have Canadian
Tom.
Whiskey? What's
Tom.
Wrong with it? Scotch?
Kahlua?
Tom.
Kahlua?
Tom.
Oh. Tom. I'll have some Kahlua.
Tom. Until That's I explained the joke, you didn't know what he meant, right? Do you agree?
Is that no good?
What's that?
Until I explained it, you didn't know what he meant, right?
What did now explain again?
The Asian guy says stoli with the twist. He means story with the twist. So instead of three bears, he says four bears, and that's the twist.
Oh yeah,
that's the joke he just told.
Yeah, no, I know.
He didn't now, the
no,
joke.
I did, you know, you're right. I did not get it until
okay,
you until you explained
you.
It.
So you just laughed.
But he's being polite.
Yes.
You're like, you've told it three times. That.
I didn't get the Stoli story part.
Why didn't you say I don't get it?
I don't know. I assumed I was stupid.
I don't want your crocodile goddamn laughs. Jesus Christ.
It's not a crocodile laugh. I figured, you know what, I don't
what
quite
am I,
get
2
it.
Years old? I'm a professional comedian.
I just figured I didn't. It was over my head. I'll pretend I'm
too sophisticated. Yeah.
Maybe
for
I'll figure it out halfway through the laugh. Oh shit! I still don't get it. Whatever. No one's gonna call me on it. And then fucking Sam comes up and fucking nails me on it. Anyway.
No one understood it. You've got 40,000 people listening, right?
No.
They're gonna be.
I like how you have no idea. One day you're like, there's only 400 people watching.
Yeah.
So I don't give a fuck what I say. There's 4 billion people when you count the internet and the telephone with the.
Yeah, and when you count the fact that they could copy it and send it. Yeah. Forever. I mean, look what happened to, you know, to Kramer. You know, one false move on this Webovision, it's everywhere.
That's right, guys.
Why well, what are you saying? You harbor insane racism that you're fucking always afraid that might spurt out?
What Kramer said.
I'm just waiting for a big uncomfortable moment so we can start to get some more viewers around here, you know?
Norm loves it.
That's what I thought you meant.
Yeah, no, I mean, I'm just saying it's interesting. It's all interconnected. It's all on YouTube. Everything we say, anything we do could end up, you know, and that's why I kind of, you know.
What do you think of Paris, man? She said it, nobody give a fuck.
All right, Norm,
what did she do?
Whatever.
Huh? Well, no, that's true, but nobody should care about that.
She said the N-word. Nobody cares.
She said the because N-word, she's not a serious, she was dancing, it was
she's
5 years
She's not a serious
ago.
Figure, yeah. Like Kramer.
Right, I didn't see that video. We can look at that video right now, actually, which is interesting. You know what's cool about this? We can actually go to CNN.com right now on here and steal their content. I mean, nobody's sort of told us not to do that yet, so I'm assuming...
Well, they stole it.
Well, I mean, look, we can go to CNN.com, and there's probably something on here about some video we can look at, like...
Oh, look how pretty.
You know, White House near panic. We can steal this content right now, courtesy of CNN.com.
Was it White House?
Yeah, actually, if White House is in panic, why don't we steal it right now?
Yeah, the Paris Hilton video you're referring to.
In any administration, it's all about shaping and controlling the message. But the Libby trial has revealed a White House in near panic over accusations its pre-war intelligence was flawed.
Look at that. The White House is in panic. Libby.
Well, they were in panic.
That's on the show now.
The president said he was going to fire the person that said those things.
But this is
it's crazy.
Just cutting
but
a
meanwhile, all this fucking political shit's going on, and meanwhile you're going, well, now I'm never going to get to fuck that Brad from Guest Magazine.
Anna Nicole Smith.
What are you talking about? Well, he didn't say that.
No, I've just been thinking that.
You can't.
Well,
anyway.
You've been saying to yourself.
I asked if we're better off.
Yeah, no, well, there she is right there.
Yeah, now she's dead.
She's dead. You can't
now she just elevated herself.
Because all you want to do is fuck her. And as soon as she's dead, you're like,
no,
well,
you wanted to save her. You wanted to save her.
No, somebody, I don't know her. She's a stranger.
Somebody should have
I know, but you
in,
knew she was unhappy and flawed, and you thought, like, you could make her happy.
No, yeah, I missed Marilyn.
Let's move to
only,
something a little more positive one. Here than look at this. Rare white lions frolicking in the snow on CNN.
Oh, well, this upsets me more than...
It's always heartwarming to see a six-month-old playing in the snow for the first time. No matter what the species.
These are white lions?
These white lion cubs seem happy enough with the cold white stuff,
where
blissfully
are they?
Unaware of the excitement surrounding them. These four are the first white lion cubs to be born in Britain. More importantly,
they're in Britain.
White lion population some 130 worldwide.
And they only occur very, very rarely when you get both parents with the suitable recessive genes meet and breed and to create that white lion. It's a very, very rare.
That's too much of that, but it's interesting.
What kind of tiger is that?
It's a rare white lion.
It's a lion.
Oh, it's a lion.
But I just find
but it's not a real lion. It's a lion in captivity.
Yeah. Hey, you know what's the coolest? That tiger got to eat that magician dude, and then they didn't even kill him.
What's this?
A lion ate a magician.
Roy.
Yeah, Roy.
Oh, yeah, the tiger, yeah.
In Vegas, tiger, whatever.
Yeah. Hey, is there any YouTube video of Roy getting eaten by the tiger?
Hey, now there would be. Now people would be watching.
Can you find
in the
any
audience.
Of that, Bill? Find something, Bill. There's got to
be
something.
Yeah, for
on
sure.
There.
Yeah, they'd have it now.
Some mortuary footage or something.
Hey, I don't think I like whiskey, man. Is there anything like less crazy than that?
The one that you
like is a Kahlua. Kahlua, yeah.
The one that you might like. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Oh, he like.
Hey, man, check this out.
Looks like it was taken from a bar.
I know, it does.
It looks like you grabbed it from a bar, because that's like it measures the shots.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
what's
the hell
is that? What's that's cool.
I'm sorry. Can somebody get me a. Who the hell?
What
the
your dog will lap it up.
Who the hell? What the heck? I'm sorry, Norm. This is really embarrassing.
Yeah,
hello, you're on the air. Where are you calling from?
Nova Scotia.
Nova Scotia.
No, I don't mean that way.
Air Sam, take us home. Nova Scotia, man. Here you go, boys.
To Nova Scotia.
The
Nova
Whalers. Scotia.
Thanks for the locks, man.
How you doing, Norm Macdonald? What's up?
Thanks. Hey, Steve, you want to play another song?
Wait. I'm winded. Nova
Scotia. You want to take some more Skype, people? Nova Scotia, how you doing?
I'm pretty good.
You like that Stomp and Tom Connor song about Nova Scotia?
Stomp and Tom Connor? What about him?
Do you like that song he does about
Everybody
Nova Scotia?
Has the same reaction to Norm.
But what? Stomp and Tom Connor has a song that's the name of your fucking town. You never heard of it?
Yeah.
Fort Hawkesbury?
Stoli with a twist.
That's a different
one. No. What's your town called?
Port Hawkesbury.
Port Hawkesbury.
That's a fucking name of a Stompin' Tom Connor song.
Do you know who Stompin' Tom Connors is, sir?
That would be the highlight of your fucking shit town.
It's the only reason you should even really get up in the morning.
Exactly.
Do you know this song?
I wish I did.
You don't know
this song? Hang up, because you're more interesting.
The story.
What's the story? You're from Ottawa.
From the Chippewa.
You're from
down.
Ottawa.
Yeah.
What's the fucking Stompin' Tom called? What's the Stompin' Tom called? Song about Ottawa.
About Ottawa?
Yeah.
About Ottawa. Oh, yeah. Geez, I don't know.
I can't help you. I want
Big Joe Mafra?
Oh, I was going to say that.
Yeah.
But why was I going to say that, though? Is that really about Ottawa?
Yeah.
Is it really?
You got to look it up on YouTube. I don't know if that
Big
have
Joe Mafra is the name of the song? My father
Big Joe Mafra sailed down to Ottawa, all the way to Ottawa in just one day. Hey, hey.
I never heard the song, but I knew
my father has sang that song all my life because my brother's name is Joe, and he always says, Mafra Joe.
That's cool.
Mafra Joe.
And it's an Ottawa song, and you don't know it?
I didn't know it was an Ottawa song.
Yeah.
I know that song.
So you got to get that song. You got to get that fucking song.
Okay, let's take one last Skype caller. It's we've been on the air for a couple hours
like way
now.
Too long.
So we got to go, right?
Yeah, we're gonna take Steve. Why don't you play a song and let's call it.
Why can't you fuckers stay late? What is this horse shit?
No, we can keep going.
Does it cost an extra $15 a minute?
No, we can keep going. We can go. You want to take a few more calls?
I don't know.
You call it. I just don't want.
We just want you to feel abused.
Feel like I'm like you know.
Abusing you.
We'll just keep going.
Who's got a light? I'm going to start smoking again.
No, don't do that.
I could use a cigarette myself.
Norm hasn't smoked since New Year's.
I know, but I wouldn't.
It's been very hard for him to smoke.
Steven from Florida is a first-time Skyper. Oh, here we have some people writing in on the I am who can't go on the Toronto. I got Norm's joke right away.
Well, we've got 500 people
now
there.
We're polling the audience?
You don't want to poll the audience.
Oh, that's
you're
not
going
good.
Like, oh, well,
there's some you can't read. Because they know exactly what to say. You know what I mean?
Is it from Florida?
Oh, boy. Norm, what's your best vomit story? That's South Carolina.
It's
Shanghai,
up.
China. I don't know.
What, Shanghai is offended?
Dirty work from New Jersey, dirty work rules.
A lot of people love Norm's film, Dirty Work.
I love that movie.
That's no question.
Hey, Tom, what's up?
Wait, did Bob Saget direct that movie? He did, right?
Yeah.
That's awesome. I talked. Bob was here a couple of days ago.
Yeah, no, I heard it.
Yeah. Was that fun to do with Bob?
Sure.
You guys hang out still a lot?
No, never.
Why don't you and Bob come by together one night? That'd be fun.
Oh, that'd be fun, yeah.
Funny group. Line two.
What is it?
There is really no line two. I mean, like, line two is very
important. Call.
Yeah. No, line two
for the VIP.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Why do you have to mention Michael Vicious, boys? That's ancient history.
Wait, who's this?
This is the guy that owns
Laugh Factory. He's the guy that owns the Laugh Factory. His name is Jamie Masada.
Hey, Jamie, how are you?
He's a bad guy,
but
though.
Explain to him who he is. Michael Richards made his comments at the Laugh Factory.
You were so banned. You don't talk about the Laugh Factory on Sunset Boulevard. The cover charge for tonight, $12. We have John Marley. We have a lot of people.
Really
and you don't
Jamie?
Make the names.
Oh.
Hey, how come you let Michael? How long did it take you to get rid of Michael Richards after that? After he said that word on your stage?
Well, he had to come back every night to apologize for a week. He had to come on.
He had to apologize every night for a week. But you were making some money off of him, so it was okay.
But it, what,
I help out because South, if you say you're from South Central and if there's room in the back, you get in for free. But you can't push people. That'd be good. And you, and it's a law, and you don't say that word.
Why didn't you ban him immediately after he said it? Why did you wait till another day and for the apology?
Well, you know,
this is not Jamie Masada. We were talking about the Laugh Factory today, though, because we were thinking, Bill and I, we work here at the channel, Bill and I. Bill comes up at 10 in the morning, and we have meetings.
Bill Schneitzer.
Yeah, Bill Schneitzer.
But yeah, Bill does a good job.
Bill and I had a lunch meeting today at Art's Deli. A lunch meeting, our first lunch meeting.
Wow.
We discussed some important things at the channel. And the most important thing going on at the channel right now is we want to build a portable studio, a movable studio like this, something that is three cameras, small, that we can move, like, kind of like Jamie Masada from the Laugh Factory. If we wanted to come down to the Laugh Factory and, say, do the show from your stage one night and have Norm as a guest and have
that'd be fantastic.
With Skype on the stage, audience there, Skype callers talking about messing with an audience, it would be. We could do some weird stuff, like on a slow night, you know, like on a Wednesday night.
Could be like an RV.
We'll do is we'll get a truck. We'll bring this desk. We put these stupid chairs. We bring three cameras and what's called a New Tech TriCaster. We'll have the Skype. The people can call in, talk to the audience. They can talk to.
Well, if it's slow, I got to make the money to help the aspirin American.
But who is this really? This is Fred.
Fred Stoller.
Who is Fred?
Fred Stoller is this guy that always phones in and tries to be funny by acting like Jamie Masada.
You asked him to.
It's such a specialized gig. I don't know when it ever.
I know. I'm ruining the integrity of the show. I'm sorry.
Wait, did you ask Fred Stoller to call in and pretend he was Jamie Masada?
Yeah,
he
was cut off.
No, I asked him 6 weeks ago on a radio station when the story was big.
Yeah.
Trying to reheat it to do this Jamie thing.
You wanted to create like a fake thing?
This I know nothing about unless he told me to do it.
I didn't ask him to do it.
Oh.
Hey, but he's really funny guy. He's a really nice, funny guy. He's very funny. You know Fred Stoller.
You know, play along. Pretend.
Yeah. Jamie, could we do that? Practice
you're like Johnny Carson, like Hones, and pretend.
Jamie, we would like to do that.
Pretend it's Jamie.
We'd like to come down and set up and do ask a little
ask
show.
Ask how Norm is at the Laugh Factory. Has Norm ever caused any trouble in the Laugh Factory?
Be a Johnny Carson.
I tried to ask him, but...
Okay, try now.
Jamie.
Yes.
No,
the Jamie thing has to be over.
No,
we're going to
start the Jamie thing for 1 second, and then we're going to stop the Jamie thing.
Well, we'll start. Here's Jamie Masada. Jamie, how are you, man? You want to talk to Tom?
Yeah, buddy, Tom.
Hey, we've got Jamie Masada on the line here, of course, from the Laugh Factory. We've had quite a brouhaha over there. With Kramer, Michael Richards. What's going on with all of that?
Well, we have to, you know, make the money for Laugh Factory. We're very conscious about not saying the bad words. We ban you and we fine you, and all the money goes to I Help the South Central.
Oh, okay.
Anytime anyone says an N-word anywhere, they have to send me $3, and Kramer has lots of money, so he should help too.
$3.
Anytime anyone says it anywhere, I get money, and I help aspirin Americans out.
Per N-word.
Wrong. I get the extra dollar.
$3 per N-word. Okay, good. Well, good. Well, thank you, Jamie. Thank you for calling tonight.
The real reason I called, are you guys going to get a bite? Because I was waiting around.
No, Laura.
Yeah.
What? Can I ask
a fight?
He wants to know if you guys, after the show, if you're going to grab a bite somewhere.
Well, so. Get something to eat.
He's no longer Jamie Masada.
Yeah, now he just wants a sandwich.
He actually is like Jamie, is money grubbing.
You phone a person's cell phone.
Tom, can I ask you something?
You don't see this on fucking Larry King Live?
Yeah, we're on
Thank
the
you,
air
Larry,
here.
Thank you, Larry,
buddy.
Yes, Arafat. I just want to say, John, if you're listening, the Pizza Hut at 6.
We're doing a show here. Who the hell does this Fred guy think he is? Okay, Steve, let's Let's end it now. This is awesome. Norm Macdonald, thank you so much. That was so fun.
Yeah, it was really fun. Yeah.
What a great Friday night.
Yeah, right.
Tom, you are a genius. What a pleasure to be here.
Oh, thank you, guys. I appreciate it a lot. I really do. No, I mean, because, I mean, this is really exciting for me to have you.
A little wild,
you guys come by. And Norm, thank you. It's an honor. My hometown, you know, I've always...
Ottawa.
It's great to have you.
Jacket.
I hope you just come back anytime you want. We're doing
really
this all the time. This is awesome.
It's really fun.
Steve, why don't you play a few songs for us?
I'm going to play us out.
And I want to say, play a couple of songs. Let's not go off the air right away. But I do want to say, from here in Los Angeles, California, on the National Webovision, thank you very much to all of you who have been watching tonight, and to Norm Macdonald especially. Thanks for coming down.
Thanks, man. Good day. We're all slippery.
It's been fun. Yeah. Cheers. Good night, everybody. Have a good weekend.
Bye.
Okay, cheers.
This is a good night song. Well, the sun dives into the ocean. Well, the sun dives into the sea. And the darkness sets in motion. The shadows falling down on me. And twilight time comes crashing down. The darkness falls without a sound. I'm lost and found in twilight time. Now the moon over my shoulder. Now the moon is over my head. And the air is getting colder. Pretty soon it's time for bed. And twilight time comes crashing down. The darkness falls without a sound. I'm lost and found in twilight time. A little mood lighting, I like that. Now I lay me down to sleep, pray to the Lord my soul to keep. If I die before I wake, never see the day break again. Now the stars are scattered above here. Now the stars, they cover the sky. And if you would tell me you love me, I light up like a firefly. And twilight time comes crashing down. The darkness falls without a sound. I'm lost and found in twilight. Twilight. Twilight time. Thank you. Good night. Good night. We love you, Webo.